Come to think of it, was there not another task we were to see to somewhere nearby? We shall have to decide which is the most pressing. We cannot do everything at once.
And should my story entertain you? Nay, even if it shouldn't, I would greatly appreciate a coin or two to soothe my throat with a mug of ale. Now, listen close, as today I shall tell of a serpent with powers most fell. Our hero ventured into a shrine long enclosed, whereupon he found serpent and soldiers in battle opposed. Though to the soldiers' aid he would fain have leapt, unease overtook him, so behind a pillar he crept. And not a moment too soon, for there came a flash of light, ere the room filled with screams, soldiers wailing at their plight. Then the shrine grew deathly still, and our hero was all alone. But every last soldier had been transformed into stone. Wary of his foe, and with presence of mind, the man crept up to the pillar upon which it was entwined. Seeing his moment, he unsheathed his blade and brought the pillar low in a thundering cascade. The gloating serpent was caught by surprise, and with a pitiful hiss, 'neath the pillar it writhed. Till mustering swiftly the last of its might, to the depths of the shrine did the monster take flight. Thus with a wit as sharp as his sword.
A crime committed here will see one confined to jail. I've heard that jailers are paid a pittance, despite the hardships of their work. Then a bribe might avail us, should the time come.
Gather round, treat your ears to a tale by a master storyteller. And should my story entertain you? Nay, even if it shouldn't, I would greatly appreciate a coin or two to soothe my throat with a mug of ale. Now, listen close, as today I shall tell of a serpent with powers most fell. Our hero ventured into a shrine long enclosed, whereupon he found serpent and soldiers in battle opposed. Though to the soldiers' aid he would fain have leapt, unease overtook him, so behind a pillar he crept. And not a moment too soon, for there came a flash of light, ere the room filled with screams, soldiers wailing at their plight. Then the shrine grew deathly still, and our hero was all alone. But every last soldier had been transformed into stone. Wary of his foe, and with presence of mind, the man crept up to the pillar upon which it was entwined. Seeing his moment, he unsheathed his blade and brought the pillar low in a thundering cascade. The gloating serpent was caught by surprise, and with a pitiful hiss, 'neath the pillar it writhed. Till mustering swiftly the last of its might, to the depths of the shrine did the monster take flight.
This might contain useful information. Shall we take a closer look?
And who was our hero? Why, needless to say, it was the father of House Berkeley, which lives on to this day. Gather round, treat your ears to a tale by a master storyteller. should my story entertain you. Nay, even if it shouldn't, I would greatly appreciate a coin or two to soothe my throat with a mug of ale. Now, listen close, and your focus apply to this tale of a giant who touches the sky. Our hero, oft forgotten by history in spite of his worth, awoke one fell morning to proper birth.
Need anything? Got some good things on offer. I enjoy this work. Keeps me on my toes. Business could be better, but I've weathered worse. Many thanks.
Our packs are heavier, and our purses far lighter. We've a journey to prepare for, after all. We can't afford to cut corners.
Gather round, treat your ears to a tale by a master story.
Much appreciated.
I'd heard tell of a beggar doing well for himself, so I came out here to learn his ways. But it's clear this storytelling's got little to do with his wealth. So where's he get his coin, then? Makes a man wonder, it does. Could be he's involved in something untoward, eh?
Gather round!
They say the sovereign was bathed in the... And yet he draws breath. We hope his majesty shall recover soon.
I'm always willing to lend a helping.
Gather round. Treat your ears to a tale by a master storyteller. And should my story entertain you? Nay, even if it shouldn't, I would greatly appreciate a coin or two to soothe my throat with a mug of ale. Now, listen close, and your focus apply to this tale of a giant who touches the sky. Our hero, oft forgotten by history in spite of his worth, awoke one fell morning to rumbling earth. In a panic he started, out the front door he leapt, to behold what had approached a night as he slept. 'Twas a mysterious figure, but be it friend or foe, on shaking legs did he approach, the better to know. Yet he did not get near, for afore him stretched the sea. The figure was striding through waters up to the knee. This realization explained the bizarre. What had appeared close was being seen from afar. For truly, the figure was mammoth in size. Tall enough to be blinded by the clouds in the skies. One thing was certain, should it walk upon land, no city.
Ah, now here's a surprise. A splendid discovery. Interesting. I shall have to inform my own master of this.
Aye, in the face of his valor, the gigantus did pale. But who among you can name the hero of our tale? 'Twas none other than Lord Rosamond, who, needless to say, was the father of House Berkeley, which lives on to this day. Gather round! Treat your ears to a tale by a master storyteller. And should my story entertain you, nay, even if it shouldn't, I would greatly appreciate a coin or two to soothe my throat with a mug of ale. Now, listen close, and your focus apply to this tale of a giant who touches the sky. Our hero, oft forgotten by history in spite of his worth, awoke one fell morning to rumbling earth. In a panic he started, out the front door he leapt, to behold what had approached a night as he slept. 'Twas a mysterious figure, but be it friend or foe, on shaking legs did he approach, the better to know. Yet he did not get near, for afore him stretched the sea. The figure was striding through waters up to the knee. This realization explained the bizarre. What had appeared close was being seen from afar. For truly, the figure was mammoth in size, tall enough to be blinded by the clouds in the skies. One thing was certain, should it walk upon land, no city, no mountain would outlast its hand. So he challenged its ingress with voice loudly drawn, and in an instant, the giant was gone. Aye, in the face of his valor, the gigantus did pay.
Unless I am much mistaken, we have caused a visit to a place not far from here. Perhaps we ought to go there first. What say you, Arisen?
Is the father of House Burton, which lives on to this day.
Said to my thoughts that dark parts this place.
'Tis so dull when there's nothing doing.
Got to work if I'm to put bread on the table. Their nobles do nothing but guzzle sweetmeats and ale.
How did I end up here anyhow?
This place offers a view of the sea. I imagine we would not escape a plunge into the water's depths.
ages time for to a be fight. Heading.
Not my kind of place, this. Dusty. Got a hankering for anything in particular?
You looking for a fight?
Ours is a show unrivaled in all the land.
I've naught to say to you.
All this hustle and bustle.
Is it true you're the Arisen? Only, I seem to recall someone else boasting of being the Arisen over in the tavern about 6 months ago. Just be sure you play your part well, whatever the truth. The Arisen takes the crown here in Vermond, after all. A fellow Drake or two, and I reckon you'll earn the people's faith.
Whatever it is, I'll have to hear it another time.
What would you of me? Oh.
Well met. I assume you'll be starting off with a mug of the good stuff. Keep those orders coming. This fearsome world of ours is best met with stiff drinks and cheery hearts, I say.
No time to talk, I'm afraid. I'm a busy man.
Another day, another adventure.
Life's been pretty kind to me.
Interested in my wares?
Easy pickings. I ought to be getting back to.
Time to be heading.
Stock up on the basics.
Go on,
flowers.
Have a look.
My back for someone else.
Drink is a vice of lesser.
Interested in my wares?
My
I end up
lots to do.
A day of rest.
Oi there! The ale flows aplenty here, courtesy of yours truly. So ne'er mind your coin purse. Drink your fill, my friend.
Well met. I assume you'll be starting off with a mug of the good stuff. Keep those orders coming. This fearsome world of ours is best met with stiff drinks and chip.
Interested in my...
What would you of me?
I'm always willing to lend a helping hand.
Wish I'd been born a nobleman.
Think about the loss.
Do to neglect proper nutrition.
Look at him. Interested in my wares?
To be getting
home. Oh, this won't do. I'm in no fit state to perform.
This ain't my problem.
Life's been pretty kind to me.
Go on, have a look.
It's obvious.
A hard day's work is it too?
Ain't nothing but trouble lurking here.
Time to be heading.
Not like
interested in my wares.
It wouldn't do to neglect proper nutrition.
Look at him. Bunch of careless fools.
If you've naught to say, I'd best be...
You fond of those eyes? Keep them to yourself.
Got any tales to liven up my day?
Almost wish all would happen to shake things up.
Interested in my wares?
I'd sooner not associate with drunkards.
All this hustle and bustle puts me right at home.
Go on, have a look. A few hours' sleep ought to help order my thoughts.
Be done.
Gonna make it a coin here.
Interested in my wares?
Lots to do.
Suppose I'm best heading home. I pity those content to live in idleness. Go on, have a look.
Look at him. Bunch of careless fools.
I'm in fine fettle today.
That's a crowd and a half.
I pity those content to live in idleness. Interested in my wares?
This is my sort of place. The more the merrier.
I'm tired of breaking my back.
The hour's grown late. Hilda's going to have my hide.
Stock up on the basics.
How'd I wind up here anyhow?
Headache's driving me. Come to think of it, was there not another task we were to see to somewhere nearby? We shall have to decide which is the most pressing. We cannot do everything at once.
Wonder if there's any easy work to be had.
Right, door's locked. That should do it.
I didn't have to work to earn my bread.
Wonder if there's any easy work to be had.
No one's coming to my rescue, as I well know.
So all sides.
When does my watch end?
I've
got a bread on the table. Somehow my feet always carry me.
Time to head to market, methinks.
Mark Body's not forgiven me for last night's scuffle.
When does my watch end?
I'm wondering if it's too early for dinner.
Got to sell off what I can while I'm in town.
Hi, sir. What I can do for you? What? You mean to say my Albert's a noble and has only been pretending to be a beggar? That can't be true. Earning a living in the slums isn't easy, but Albert and I, we promised each other we'd try our hardest to make ends meet. We've been working toward that all this time. And you're saying 'tis all a lie. I don't want to believe such madness, but... Nor can I deny that these garments are my husband's. Pray, tell me where you found them. I must see this for myself.
Shall we visit the manor, as the maid bid? Then follow me. I'll lead the way. We're in your hands, sir. Much obliged. Follow me, if you would. Just yonder looks to be a good spot for harvesting ingredients. No harm in picking a...
Oh, you came, sir. I must confess, I feared you would not. But I forget myself.
You must be wondering why I asked you here. I should like to speak with an acquaintance of yours, a child with whom I espied you conversing. She is the spitting image of my young master, you see. 'Tis my hope that she might take his place for a time, thereby granting him a reprieve from his sorry situation.
Diana, would you paint my mother a criminal? Perhaps I ought to be the one to explain.
Young master, I meant no offense.
Diana has the right of it, though the situation is not nearly so dire as she makes it sound. I seek only the freedom to leave my own home. My mother is bedridden, you see, and her mind is not so sharp as it once was. Whenever I am absent, she grows terribly distressed. By leaving a lookalike in the house, I hope to ensure her peace of mind while I attend to matters of my own. Would you be willing to lend your assistance? Splendid! Thank you so very much.
'Twas in the slums that I witnessed you speaking with the girl. Would you be so kind as to bring her here?
You're a right pain, you are.
It is my duty to devote my life.
Yeah? What is it?
Arisen! I was hoping you'd come by, so I could thank you again for all your help. You wanted to ask me a favor this time? All right. How can I help? So, this noble boy wants me to pretend to be him? I'm not sure that'd work. I mean, I don't know the first thing about being a noble. Besides, are you sure we can trust these people? It all sounds a bit fishy to me. All right, I'll do it. But if I'm not very good at it, it's not my fault, okay?
my sword arm could use some work.
Wouldn't say anything but a big
sword arm. Time to hit the sack.
Over here, if you please.
Look, young master. She's here.
Indeed. I could be staring into a mirror. Diana, will you dress her and instruct her in her role?
As you wish, young master. This way, if you please, miss.
What a kindness you've done me. Now I can go and fetch a gift for mother. I'm hoping a little cheer will aid her in her recovery, and a flower from Melv seems just the thing. She was born there, you see. No doubt her days would be brighter with a memento of her old home by her bedside.
All is ready, young master. You need only finish your preparations for the journey.
See. What else must I bring? Ah, I almost forgot. In that goes. Let's see. What else must I bring? Ah, I almost forgot. In that goes.
I'll teach him a lesson he won't soon forget.
Let's see. What else must I bring? Ah, I almost forgot. In that goes.
The lands around Melv are rife with poisonous flora. I'd hoped to pack an antidote for the young master, but the shops had none to spare. 'Tis not only poison the plants inflict, but drowsiness besides. Might there not be a curative that accounts for both?
Let's see. Ah, I almost forgot.
The lands are out. 'Tis not only poison the plant. The lands around Melv are rife with poisonous flora. I'd hope to pack an ant is not only poison the plants inflict, but...
see. Ah, I almost forgot. What else must I bring? Ah, I almost forgot. In that goes.
The lands around. It is not only poison, the.
You know. The roads around Malve are supposed to be... I heard the safest way to get there is to carry something that reeks of Cyclops with you, because it'll scare all the monsters away.
It seems Master Sebastian is lacking a few supplies. Shall we gather what springs to mind?
Look at my wares.
Need anything? Stop by again soon.
Not buying? That's just as well. Better to be selective than wasteful. The Arisen is ever prudent in the application of coin. oxcarts make for relatively safer travel. Fewer monsters are to be found in the main road, though carts travel only by the sun's light.
have never heard such nonsense.
Well met, sir. How might I be of... service? Always a pleasure.
This looks as good as...
They say the soft seams driving away the dragon took quite... It is a right miracle he yet lived.
Good day to you.
I'm always willing to lend a help.
Say, well, if you do visit, I hear he sets out as if that wasn't queer enough. I cannot fathom his obsession.
Not sure what you want with it.